हेलो फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द नेक्स्ट पॉइंट अबाउट द बी सेल, दैट इज द एक्टिवेशन ऑफ बी सेल्स. प्रीवियसली वी आर ऑलरेडी डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द डिफरेंट मैच्यूरेशन स्टेजेस ऑफ द बी सेल्स. नाउ वी आर स्विच ओवर टू द एक्टिवेशन ऑफ बी सेल्स. नाउ द initial maturation of these B cells, these are carried out within the primary lymphoid organ, that is the bone marrow, that we are already discussed. Similarly to that of the T lymphocytic cells, the B lymphocytic cells, these are also selected through the positive and negative selection within the bone marrow, or there is a proper education of these cells to interact with the antigens within the secondary lymphoid organ. Preferentially, whenever there is the developmental stages of these immune cells, at that time the most important thing it is during their education, these are educated to get differentiated in between the self and non-self antigen. Majorly within our body, on each of the cell there is the presence of the antigens, but these are not foreign to our body or these are not dangerous for our body. Means these are considered as a self antigen. So it is most important that these immune cells which are developed within our body, majorly these can differentiate in between this self and non-self antigen. If these can't recognizing these self antigens, or if these are not differentiating these two things, preferentially these are responsible for causing the autoimmune diseases. For that purpose, majorly there is this proper education of these immune cells to differentiate in between the self and non-self antigens. And if suppose within these developmental stages, some of the cells these are observed, like these are showing the higher interaction with the self antigens, such type of the cells, these are get destroyed before the next progression steps, that is through the apoptosis or through the clonal deletion. Or majorly again these are get properly developed, means there are the again changes, these are occurred within these cells through the activation of the recombination activating genes. That we are already discussed in my previous video. So preferentially today we are focused on the activation of these B cells. No doubt after this maturation stages, there is the transfer of these mature B cells from the bone marrow towards the secondary lymphoid organ. Now before switching towards the activation of B cells, firstly we are discuss about the subsets of these B cells. Now within the circulation there are the three types or the three subset of the B lymphocytic cells, these are observed. The first one, it is the B1 B cells. The second one, it is follicular B cells. The third one, it is the marginal zone B cells or the marginal B cells. Now means these are the three important subsets of the B lymphocytic cells. The first one, it is the B1 B cells. Second one, it is the follicular B cells. And the third one, it is the marginal B cells. Now out of these three subsets, these B1 B cells, these are formed during the fetal life. We know that during the development of the fetus, preferentially some of the cells, there is the starting of the process of the hematopoiesis. During this fetal life, there is the development of some of the B lymphocytic cells within the fetal liver or within the bone marrow. Such type of the cells which are developed during the fetal life within the bone marrow, these are called as the B1 B cells. Now the another specific characteristics which are related with these B1 B cells, that is, these are expressing only the IgM type of the immunoglobulin molecules on their surfaces, and there is no presence of IgD. Normally, whenever we are discussing about the characteristics of these B lymphocytic cells, on the surface of the B lymphocytic cells, there is the presence of the two immunoglobulin molecules as an antigen receptor. The first one, it is the IgM, and the second one, it is the IgG type of the immunoglobulin molecules. Now, but within these B1 B cells, preferentially there is only presence of the IgM immunoglobulin molecule. There is presence of only IgM type of immunoglobulin molecule on their surfaces. It is the one of the most important differentiating characteristics of these B1 B cells. Second one, it is they are formed during the fetal life. Now the third characteristics, it is majorly these B1 B cells, these are having ability of the self renewal. These are self renewing. Now within my previous video we are already discussing about the hematopoiesis process. Within that we consider that the process, the hematopoietic stem cell, which is the mother cell, it is having this self renewal ability, means they are control their number or they are increase in number by the cell division, which is not possible for other type of the cells, that is either it is a follicular B cells or the marginal B cells. No doubt there may be the transfer into the progressional stage, there may be the expansion of these cells, but there is no self renewal ability within these cells. So these B1 B cells, these are having the self renewing ability. Again, these are having the short lifespan. They are having the short lifespan. And another one of the most important characteristics about these B1 cells, it is these are having the low amount of the antigenic specificity or the lower range of the antigenic specificity. These are not most diverse antigenic specificity. There is absence of diverse antigenic specificity. So these are the characteristics of the B1 B cells. Majorly within the peritoneal cavity and different cavities, there is also presence of these B1 B cells. And within the some of the secondary lymphoid organ, whenever there is the presence of these peritoneal cavities, within that majorly there is the presence of these B1 B cells. Now the next one, it is the follicular B cells. Follicular B cells. Now the name itself indicates the specificities of these B cells. Now these follicular B cells, these are the mature B cells which are developed within the bone marrow. Then they are transported towards the secondary lymphoid organs, and specifically these follicular B cells, these are present within the lymph node. Okay, which is the most important secondary lymphoid organ, and it is responsible for trapping the antigens which are present within the lymph. These are responsible for trapping antigens which are present within the lymph. That is the filtration of the lymph. This function will be done by the lymph node, which is the secondary lymphoid organ. And it is the site for the activation of the B and T lymphocytic cells, as these are get introduces towards the different types of the antigens within this secondary lymphoid organ, and at that site there is the activation of these B lymphocytic cells. Now within these lymph nodes, we know that there is the presence of the primary and secondary follicles. So preferentially within these primary follicles, there is the appearance of these follicular B cells, as these are present within the follicles. So the name, it is the follicular B cells. Name, it is the follicular B cells. And on the surface of these follicular B cells, there is the presence of both IgM and IgD type of the immunoglobulin molecules. Now after the antigenic stimulus, preferentially these are responsible for producing both the IgM and IgG type of the immunoglobulin molecule. After the activation, these are able to produce both IgG and IgM type of the immunoglobulin molecules. Now the third one, it is the marginal B cells. Now these are present within the spleen. We know that within the spleen, the major component which is present, that is the marginal zone, it is one of the part present within the spleen, which is the secondary lymphoid organ. within that there is the presence of these B cells, and due to that, from the their site of location, the name it is given, that is the marginal B cells. Marginal B cells which are present within the spleen, and these are responsible for recognizing the antigens which are present within the blood, or these are responsible for fight with the blood antigens. Antigens which are present within the blood, because the function of the spleen, it is to filter the blood-borne infection or the blood-borne pathogens. For that purpose, all different types of the antigens or the foreign particles which are present within the blood, these are trapped within the spleen, and these are introduced towards the B lymphocytic cell and the T lymphocytic cells which are present within the spleen, which are the secondary lymphoid organ. So these are the three different subsets of the B lymphocytic cells. Now we are switch over to the important topic, that is the activation of B cells. How these B cells, these are get activated. Now the term activation, it means there is the introduction of these B cells towards the antigen. Now those cells which are present within the secondary lymphoid organ, these are no doubt, these are the mature B cells. These are mature B cells, but these are the mature naive cells. Naive cells, it means these are those immune cells till which are not introduced to any type of the foreign particle. These are called as the naive B cells. Now whenever within the secondary lymphoid organs there is the introduction of these cells towards any type of the antigen, then there is the stimulation of these cells. There is stimulation of these cells. It is called as the antigenic stimulation. Antigenic stimulation. Now we know that within our life, there are the number of different types of the antigens which are introduced to our body, and preferentially those of these B cells which are formed within the bone marrow, then these are get transferred within the secondary lymphoid organ. Preferentially these are having the diverse group of specificity, antigenic specificity, due to the different characteristics. Means as there is the different alleles for the heavy and light chains, these are present. Then there is the somatic hypermutation, then there is the N nucleotide addition, P nucleotide addition. Then there is the recombination activating genes which are responsible for joining these different segments of the immunoglobulin molecule. For that purpose, these different type of the diversities, these are get developed within these immune cells. And as number of population of these B cells, these are present within the secondary lymphoid organ, these are interact with the antigen. And those which are showing the proper binding with the antigenic molecule, these cells, these are undergo the clonal expansion. Clonal expansion. Now the clonal expansion, clone means we know that similar type of the bodies, similar type of the bodies, means whenever the single B cell, it is interact with the antigen, and if there is a proper interaction, these cells, these means a stimulus it is given to the interior side of the cell to form the same type of the cells. It is called as the clonal expansion. Means same type of the B lymphocytic cells which are able to interact with that antigens, these are get produced within our body, and it is called as the clonal expansion. Now for that purpose, there are the two types of the stimulating signals, that is the TI and TD, that is thymus independent and thymus dependent. And thymus dependent. Thymus dependent and thymus independent type of the stimulus. Now the thymus independent, it means these are irrespective of the T lymphocytic cells. Means these are not represented by the T helper cells, or there is no interaction of the B lymphocytic cells with the T helper cells or the type of the antigens. These are directly get interact with the B lymphocytic cells, and there is the activation of B cells. It is the thymus independent. Now secondly, it is the TD, that is the thymus dependent. It is completely react interact with the T helper cells. Means those of the antigens which are present, these are interact with both the T helper cells and the B lymphocytic cells. And such type of the activation, it is called as an thymus dependent. Or in other way, whenever these T helper cells, these are get activated, these T helper cells, these are responsible for secreting the cytokines. And such type of the secreted cytokines, these are having the receptor on the surface of the B lymphocytic cells. And as these are having the receptors for the B lymphocytic cells, these are responsible for interact with that and these are get activated. Such type of the activation stage, these are grouped under the thymus dependent activation of the B lymphocytic cells. Now, for the activation, majorly there is the signals, these are present. Signal first and signal second. That is the one, it is the competence signal, and the second one, it is the progression signal. Progression signal. Now the competence signal, it means the cell become competent. Means the cell, it is ready to interact with the that antigen. It means majorly when as the number of the B cells with the different antigenic specificity, these are present. One of the cell within that population which interact with that antigen properly, it is a competent cell. So it is a, whenever this interaction it is carry out, it is a competence signal. And whenever these cells, these are undergo the clonal expansion. Clonal expansion, it is the progression step, or it is a progression signal. It is a progression signal. Now this interaction of the antigen and the immunoglobulin molecule, it is majorly only the immunoglobulin molecules, these are not responsible for this clonal expansion or activation of B cells. Other surface molecules, these are also plays an important role within this activation. Within that, the CD19, then ITAM, then the TAPA first, that is the CD81, and the CD21. This CD19, CD21 and TAPA, these are the co-receptors or the co-activators which are essential for the proper activation of the B lymphocytic cells. Now the CD19, preferentially this CD19 and other surface molecules, why these are required for the activation? Now the reason behind that, it is preferentially the immunoglobulin molecules which are present on the surface of the B lymphocytic cells, majorly these are not having the cytoplasmic tails. Means these cytoplasmic tails, these are present inside the cells. Now whenever this interaction, these are carried out, there is a signal transduction pathway. Means to the interior of the cell, a signal it is get transduced to get signal for the next developmental stages. Because before the interaction between the antigen and the immunoglobulin molecule, the cells, these are present at a G0 state or the resting state. These are present at a resting state. And it is essential to convert this resting state into the S phase, then from S phase to G1 phase, G1 to G2 phase, and then the M phase. After that, this clonal expansion it is carried out. That is the number of the cells, these are get formed through the clonal expansion. But for this stimulation of the resting state into the activation state, majorly this interaction, it is important to transfer the signal to the interior site, and these are get transferred through the cytoplasmic tails, which are giving the signal to the interior of the cells. To the within the interior of the cell, there is the presence of the signal molecules. Different signal transduction pathways, these are present. That is the tyrosine kinase based pathways, these are present for the giving the signal to the interior of the cell for this activation of the B cells. But these immunoglobulin molecules, these are not having the, or these are having very much short cytoplasmic tails. For that purpose, this CD19 molecule and other surface molecules which are present on the, that is the most important, it is the heterodimer IG alpha and beta. Similar to that of the T lymphocytic cells, the TCR, that is the T cell receptor, here these are the part of the B cell receptors. That is the heterodimer, that is the two polypeptide chain, combination of two polypeptide chain, that is the immunoglobulin alpha and beta. These are having the longer cytoplasmic tails. And due to their longer cytoplasmic tails, these are responsible for transferring the signal to the interior of the cell for the proper activation signal, development of the proper activation signal within the interior of the cells. And these resting B cells, to which there is the interaction of the B cells, these are get activated. So it is the actual process. And why such type of the other surface molecules, these are required. These are required for the proper signal transduction pathways, which are essential for the activation of B lymphocytic cells. Now the other steps, these are requiring the somatic hypermutation. Now this somatic hypermutation, it means there is the change within the paratopes which are present on the surface of immunoglobulin, which are present on the surface of B cell, that is the immunoglobulin molecule. We know that the complete immunoglobulin molecule, it is not interacting with the antigen. Only the specific part of this immunoglobulin molecule, it is responsible to get interact with the antigen. It is called as the paratope, and its respective part which is present on the antigen, it is called as the epitope. Means whenever we say that there is the antigen antibody reaction, these are carried out, it is the actual interaction, it is in between the epitope and the paratope. These are get interact with each other. And now whenever this somatic hypermutation, it is occur within, that is the, there are at the genetic level the nucleotide sequences, these are get changed, responsible for changing the amino acid sequence within the paratope, that is the variable region of immunoglobulin molecule. It is nothing but variable region of immunoglobulin molecule. Variable region of immunoglobulin molecules of both heavy and light chain. Both are having the variable region, and these are responsible for interacting with the antigen, that is the epitope of the antigen. And this somatic hypermutation, it is carried out whenever the antigenic stimulus, it is given to the cells. After that, there is the somatic hypermutation. Now, the next important step, it is the class switching. Class switching. Now the class switching, it is the process through which it is clear that which type of the immunoglobulin molecules these to be formed against that antigen. We know that there are the five different types of the immunoglobulin molecules, that is, it is IgD, IgE, IgM, IgJ, IgA and IgG. These five different types of the immunoglobulin molecules, these are present. And majorly, these are not every time all of the immunoglobulin molecules, these are get formed. So for that purpose, majorly there is a class switching procedure through which it is clear that which type of the immunoglobulin molecule it is to be get formed at that condition. Now within this, it is depending upon the secretion of cytokines. These cytokines, these are responsible for clearing that which type of the immunoglobulin molecules is to be formed. Means if there is the secretion of the interleukin 4, these interleukin 4, these are responsible for class switching from IgE to IgG. Means if the cells, other cells, these are responsible for secreting this interleukin 4, then there is the formation of IgG instead of IgE. Instead of IgE, then if there is the tumor, then the tumor growth factor or the TG of alpha. If there is the secretion of this cytokine, then there is again secretion or the development of the IgG type of the immunoglobulin molecule. Then if there is the interleukin 5, such time means at every time, whenever there is a change within the cytokine, there is the alteration within the immunoglobulin molecule which is to be get formed. For that purpose, these cytokines, these are plays an important role during this class switching procedure. Now after this, preferentially, as we say that there is the synthesis of the immunoglobulin molecules, majorly there is the differentiation of these B cells after the activation. There is differentiation of the cells. Differentiation of B cells. Now, whenever there is the differentiation of B cells, these B lymphocytic cells, these are get differentiated in between the plasma cells and the memory cells. Plasma cells and memory cells. Now we are already know that preferentially these immune responses, these are differentiated into the two types, that is the primary immune response and the secondary immune response. So within the primary immune response means whenever any type of the antigen it is first introduces to our body, the immune response which is shown by our body, it is called as the primary immune response. And within that there is the role of these plasma cells. Plasma cells, these are nothing but these are the antibody secreting cells. These are the antibody secreting cells. And these antibody secreting cells means all of the antibodies which are secreted by these plasma cells, these are of the same isotype. Means if these are secreting IgG, all of the plasma cells, these are only secreting the IgG. And these plasma cells, these are present within the germinal centers. Means as within the secondary lymphoid organ, firstly these are present within the primary follicles. After that, whenever there is the interaction of these B cells with the antigens, these are get converted into the secondary follicles. There is increase in the size of these follicles and then these are get transferred to the germinal centers. These are transferred within the germinal centers, and within germinal center this differentiation process will be carried out, that is conversion of these B lymphocytic cells into the plasma cells and the memory cells. Now whenever this differentiation it is carried out, at that time only these are able to form those of the antibodies which are interact with the antigen which is responsible for this differentiation. Means here the restriction will be get formed. Here the restricted antigenic specificity. Before the activation state, these B cells which are present within the circulations, these are different type of the B cells, these are having the different antigenic specificity. But whenever the antigenic stimulus it is given, and these are progressed towards the differentiation step, at that time these are having a single antigenic specificity. Same type of the antibodies get formed, and these are only able to interact with only that of the antigen which is responsible for their differentiation. And these plasma cells, these are having the role within the primary immune response. Means all of the antigens which are present, to which there is the interaction of these antibodies which is secreted by these plasma cells, these are interact with that and these are neutralized all of the antigens which are present within the body. And the memory cells, now these memory cells, these are not having any type of the role within the primary immune response, but these are having the role within the secondary immune response. Now this secondary immune response, it is whenever the same type of the antigens, these are introduced to our body subsequently at the second time. At that time the memory cells, these are directly recognizing that antigen, because these are having or these are storing the memory about the structure of that antigen, that is the epitope of that antigens. And immediately these are get activated. And after activation, these are get differentiated form and get converted into the plasma cells, and these are secreting the antibodies. Means the process which is required for the identification of structure of antigen, this time period it is totally get reduced within the secondary immune response, and these memory cells, these are perform this role, and majorly due to that the secondary immune response it is carry out at a higher rate as compared to that of the primary immune response. Preferentially within the secondary immune response there is the formation of IgG type of the immunoglobulin molecules, and within the primary immune response in most of the cases there is the formation of the IgM type of the immunoglobulin molecules, or within some of the mucosa associated lymphoid tissue there is the presence of the secretory type of the immunoglobulin molecules. Only the one of the type of the immunoglobulin molecule it is secretory, that is the IgA type of the immunoglobulin molecules, which are secretory in nature, which are get secreted. So these are present within that mucosa associated lymphoid tissue or other body secretions. Within that there is the presence of IgA type of the immunoglobulin molecule, that is the secretory type. So by this way there is the complete activation of the B lymphocytic cells. So it is the all over information about the activation of B lymphocytic cells. So if you like this video, please subscribe the channel and also share the video with your friends, and also click on the bell icon to get the information or notification about the incoming videos. So please stay with me and get the information about the different immunological terms. Thank you.